Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Tuesday live stream. And we're just a couple of days away from Nashville, Tennessee, in the Bitcoin conference. And I have to tell you, today, I'm feeling pretty good about the market. But we're going to talk about the Ethereum ETF. We're going to take a look at one of the largest inflows we've ever seen as far as like with the Bitcoin ETF, how the Ethereum ETF actually kind of lines up with the Bitcoin ETF in January. We'll also take a look at Solana as almost a trillion asset under management comes in and starts looking like they're going to buy into Solana. But first, I want to get into hacks. And this story is genius. I love this whole part. I love how this was done. And I think, in all honesty, we should all be doing the same. We should be hacking our friends and family and loved ones for the greater good. Here is what I am talking about. This was a story today over on X or Twitter from King with Hat. I linked his profile in the description. You can give him a follow if you'd like to so choose to. But it was quite interesting. And it made me really think about what we really should be doing to protect the people around us. Remember, it's not about how much you make, it is how much you keep. And how many people do you know who've been screwed out of their crypto or even life savings because of errors and scammers? Let me tell you, I was in the healthcare industry for 2 decades, and I can tell you many a patient who I would talk to who got scammed for their entire life savings, and it is devastating. So I have to applaud King with Hat with what he did. And here's what we got. So King says this morning, he's like, look, my dad just texted me saying he bought his first crypto today, which is a pretty great story in and of itself. Congratulations, you've orange-pilled them or red-pilled them, or this is Solana, so whatever color you want to associate that with. He said, I asked him his seed phrase and he sent it over. First of all, big mistake. Obviously, we don't want to do that. And if that happens, I think the most of us would say, hey, don't ever do that because it's a bad thing. But King took this to another level. He said, I took his $150 of Solana and sent it to my wallet. Never give your seed phrase to anyone, not even your son. Lesson one, welcome to the trenches, buddy. I have to say, bravo. That is fantastic work. Because the thing is, we have to learn from mistakes. But they don't have to be our mistakes. Unfortunately, people only learn from massive pain. So you have to kind of do these things, I personally believe, and see what will happen. Now, I've actually retweeted this out and I said, who would you rather get scammed? Would it rather be from a family member who actually gives it back? Or would it actually be from an actual scammer where you don't have a snowball's chance in hell to get your actual crypto back? I got to tell you, I'd much rather have it from my son to do that to me than some random scammer or hacker. And I have to say that if you would like to do this, I'm not condoning you to steal money from your family. I'm just saying to teach them a lesson in what not to do so when the time comes, they're protected. Anyhow, let me know what you think about that in the comment section. And the reason why I brought this up, and it could, first of all, it's a great story. But second of all, it's because of this. I didn't do a live stream yesterday. I did a couple on Sunday because of Biden dropping out. And we talked about crypto and so on and so forth. And I had some other things going on with the sports facility and some properties I just couldn't get done. But during that time, I almost got scammed, and it was amazing just how fast these things work. Now, this is Piorgi, I think that's how you say his name, but he's from Scammer Payback, and he's got a great channel, great YouTube channel, great X. Check him out, linked in the description. And what he does is he finds and tracks down scammers and tries to screw them over, just like how they would screw over us. And it's a great show, and he shows you all the tricks and all the things that you want to do to be protected. Again, not how much you make, it's how much you keep. And this was a great little snippet. Again, you can find it in the description. And I've been watching this guy for like over 2 years now. And I said, hey, I said, that's awesome. I support what you do. I hate these scamming pieces of trash. Coincidentally, I was called today. This was yesterday. An attempt was made to scam me from this number. Now, I linked this specific post in the description. If you want to call this number and see what the hell was going on with this guy, go right ahead. But I'll tell you the story. I'm not going to read from it. I'll tell you what happened. Guy called me and said, hey, is this XYZ? Is this Rob? Yes, this is him. Yeah, this is from Yahoo Control, Yahoo email. And I was like, yeah, okay, sure it is. And we've had some unfamiliar activity on your account for your email account. And is this your account? I said, yes. Is this your phone number? And I said, yes. And then he said, okay, well, you know, just make sure you don't do this and this and this and make sure you have it protected. And that's it for today. I'm like, oh, that was weird. So maybe that was real. And then he said, I'm going to send you a code. If you could tell me that code, I can protect your account. And that's where I said, look, that's never going to happen. I mean, whatever code that you text me, I'm not going to send it to you. Because obviously you can just, you know, go to my account and then try to reset it, get the code. I can give it to you and then you can break into my email account and do whatever you want to. And from that point, when I said those words to the next sentence out of his mouth, and this is a family show, so I'm going to tell you what he said, but he said essentially, F you, you worthless F something something. You are a F and F and F and da da da. I'm like, wow, what happened to the rapport we were building? I can't believe this. And at that point, I knew it was a scam. And I, of course, started to laugh at him. And I said, kid, you're a loser. You'll always be a loser. You're never going to get me. And then before he hung up, he said something very interesting. He said, you laugh now, but I'm going to do a SIM swap and I'm going to take all your crypto. And I was like, ho, 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 interesting. Interesting. So first of all, this wasn't a random attack, I don't think. This is somebody who actually knew me or knew my channel, who figured out my email, which is not that hard to find the email. And of course, the phone number, which again, is not that hard. It's, I mean, everything's on the internet these days. But I said, and then before he hung up, I said, good luck doing the SIM swap and good luck getting any of my crypto, you worthless piece of trash. And that's what it was. So why I was so, I guess, confident in my abilities here was because I've already talked to my carrier. And I said, I told them, under no circumstances should anybody be allowed to move my SIM card or swap it. Make sure that I have to come in. And there's a form that you sign. This is through T-Mobile. And that was done. So for me, it wasn't a big deal. Well, it would suck if I got SIM swapped, that's for sure. But the reason why I don't really care about the whole crypto part or the bank part or anything like that is because all or almost all of my crypto is in cold storage. You can't hack that. You can't hack Tangem. You can't hack Ledger. Tangem has had over a million, now looking at 2 million users for years now, and not one single hack. Ledger is the same way. Ledger, of course, unfortunately, did get a small hack for personal data, but all the crypto was safe. So I said, you know, I said to him, good luck, because there's not a chance in hell you're going to get it. And that was my story. And I'm hoping that if you're listening to me right now, or maybe you're watching the replay, that you have that much confidence to tell a scammer or hacker that calls you to go pound sand, because there's not a chance that they're going to get any of your crypto because you have it in cold storage, like we talk about. These are the reason why we do these things. And of course, there's some other rules that we've talked about before, which are, you know, quite simple, which are don't invest more than you can afford to lose or it's all gone. Everything's a scam until proven otherwise. Don't leave things on exchanges. We know why, right? Celsius, Voyager, BlockFi, FTX, names go on. Don't use leverage and take profits along the way. Those have helped me a lot. They might help you. Anyhow, let me just think about that in the comments section. Now that was like the old news. Let's go into some new stuff, which I thought it was pretty good. Kamala Harris. Don't worry, I'm not going to get political. But I have been talking a lot about Trump. And I said, hey, look, if the Biden administration comes along and they say something positive, I'll cover it. Well, Biden stepped down, but I like where things are going here. So this is from Bitcoin News. They said Mark Cuban says advisors close to Vice President Kamala Harris, who, let's be honest, is going to be the next or is going to carry the Democratic nomination going into the presidential election in November. I don't see anybody coming in, but let me know in the comment section. He says Kamala Harris and his team have reached out to him about crypto policy. He states, I'm getting multiple questions from her camp about crypto. So I take that as a good sign. I think that's a good sign too. The feedback I'm getting, but certainly not confirmed by the VP, is that she will be far more open to business, AI, crypto, and this is interesting, government as a service, not a software as a service, government as a service, Mark Cuban said. So Mark has no reason to lie. Maybe he's not a politician, but we all lie a little bit. But I find this as a good news and a step in the right direction. I know some people love Trump and some people hate Trump. And some people love Biden and some people hated Biden. But he's irrelevant now because he's not going to be the next president, right? And of course, we also have RFK Jr., which I hopefully will get to meet at the Bitcoin convention in Nashville coming up this week. But regardless of what's going on in the background, I know some people say, well, I don't want to be a single issue voter. Well, there you go. Now you've got two presidential candidates who would potentially carry the torch of crypto digital assets. Now, some of you might say, well, she's a liar because she's a politician. Guess what? They're all politicians. So it's up to you. I just said that I would cover this, and I did cover it. And I just want to make sure that everybody knows the story going forward. Anyhow, you know what you're gonna, let me know what you think about that in the comments. And then lastly, let's talk a little bit about the Ethereum ETF. Sorry, it wasn't as big as you might have thought it was. I don't think anybody on this channel thought it was going to be awesome. I thought we were all kind of in on consensus, pun intended, that this was going to be a buy the rumor, sell the news type of thing. So we opened up at the New York Stock Exchange, 9:30 Eastern Standard Time. Right now I'm in Mountain Time. So that would be 7:30-ish. So 7:30, opening bell, you had about 3470 for Ethereum. Then it dropped 3436. Then everybody's like, hey, wait, we got this nice ETF. And then it was a little bit of a rally, then a drop, then a rally, and then boof, drops again, then a rally, and now we're dropping again. I don't know where it's going to go. Nobody really knows. But I will just say, to take a look at how this compared to the Bitcoin ETF from the first day to the second day. The first day, January 10th, you had a net flow of 2,700 Bitcoin. And the net flow for the next day on January 11th, pretty good. 6,000, 16,000 more. And it was a little bit of a tumultuous move. And then we went up and then there was a little bit of a slump for a week or so. And then it just took off like a rocket. Now, is this going to happen? I have no idea. But I want to just make sure everybody's clear on this, which is just because we've got a monstrous amount of time on our hands and, you know, we think that, oh, okay, well, it's going to be great because, you know, this ETF is here and we're going to gobble up. I will remind you that as of yesterday, we had the most inflows, first or second most inflows in a single day by BlackRock. And it is a huge amount. Grayscale didn't sell any. Fidelity got a little bit, a little nibble. ARK bid, HODL dropped a little bit, but the net was net positive. That's total net flows, but it's still net positive for what's happening. And even as of today, we are at an all-time high of total net Bitcoin flows to ETFs. And we're not near an all-time high. Let's go back. Let me take a look. I don't want to lie to everybody. Yeah, I think the last all-time high was 73,000. We're still at 65,000. The last 24 hours went down 3.6%. So just because this ETF is here and everybody thinks it's going to be like tremendous on the first day, I didn't think it was going to happen, but I could be wrong. We got a little bit of time left. Actually, not that much at all. We'll see how it goes, but that's what we have going on in there. But I will say, and of course, let me know what you think, you know, how well this is going to do. And we'll talk about this in the Q&A as well. But I did find this quite interesting. Bitwise is going to donate 10% of the spot Ethereum ETF profits to open source developers. I have to tell you, if it's people who actually believe in a project and they're going to donate their profits, that says something about ETF. Now, I will say this, that is a hell of a tax write-off if you're giving away for donations. So either way you look at it, it's still pretty good. And what does this mean? Well, Bitwise is one of 8 fund managers set to launch a spot Ethereum ETF today. Donations will be split between 2 organizations, Protocol Guild and PBS Foundation. Protocol Guild is a grassroots funding organization that supports 170 core contributors dedicated to research and development of Ethereum. PBS Foundation is a nonprofit organization that funds open source Ethereum block relays and associated research. So they must believe in it pretty well to do that. I don't think they were doing that for Bitcoin core developers, but sure. Bitwise ZW will trade in the New York Stock Exchange with Coinbase selected as its digital asset custodian. There is one thing about this last sentence that concerns me. Coinbase is everywhere. I don't know if you guys know this, but Coinbase, and they tweeted this out today. They are responsible for 10 of 11 spot Bitcoin ETFs and 8 of the 9 newly approved ETFs. All I can say is this. Please, baby Jesus, who is above us, make sure there is no hacks. Make sure Coinbase, nothing happens to it. Because if it does, you're going to see the monstrous dips of all crashes come down. Let's hope they got everything right in line. And that's pretty much it for that piece. Oh, lastly, I forgot Solana. Don't want to get in. I promise to talk about it. Solana, just so you guys know, institutions are investing heavily into it. And it's not just that. I think there's also Grayscale Premium, like at an 8X. But regardless, look at that up in a little bit. But Hamilton Lane becomes the first asset manager to launch a fund on Solana blockchain. And if you don't know Hamilton Lane, as far as assets under management, $900 billion. That's a billion with a B, almost a trillion. And announced the launch of a private credit fund on the Solana blockchain. So, you know, some people say, well, Solana is really good for meme coins, and that's about it. I don't think that's true. I think the institutions are voting, and they're voting with their pocketbooks, and they're saying, we believe this is the one that will be the big winner. But we'll see. I personally have diversified Bitcoin, Ethereum, Solana, Cardano, TON, Avalanche, Chainlink, and a whole slew of different cryptos. So we'll see how it all works out. But that is it for today. So look, if you like today's video, give it a thumbs up. Consider subscribing. Everything we talk about is time sensitive.